It's Vicki, and today's reading is from The Language of Letting Go from September 1st, and it's about patience. Sometimes we get what we want right away. At other times, we wonder if our desires will ever be fulfilled. We will be fulfilled in the best way possible and as quickly as possible. But some things take time. Sometimes we have lessons to learn first, lessons that prepare us so we can accept the good we deserve. Things are being worked out in us and in others. Blocks in us are being removed. A solid foundation is being laid. Be patient, relax, and trust. Let go. Then let go some more. Good things are planned for us. We will receive them at the first available moment. We will have all our heart longs for. Relax and trust. Today I will identify what I want and need. Then I'll be willing to let go of it. I will devote my energy to living my life today so I may master my lessons as quickly as possible. I will trust that what I want and need is coming to me. I will let go of my need to control the details. And, of course, once again, all this stuff comes around when it's supposed to. Today on the podcast, we were talking about this very thing, about letting go of the results. And I think I talked about this week too. Who knew? But the thing is, it's not always about what we want. And, you know, it reminds me of Rolling Stones, right? You can't always get what you want, but if you try, sometimes you'll get what you need. And in this world of growth that is ever evident, consistently evident, especially right now, it's almost like I am just doing one learning experience after another learning experience after another learning experience, and being patient. It's almost like I prayed to be patient. They always say if you pray for patience, get ready to wait, right? And relax and trust, let go. And that is not always easy. It's awesome when you can do it, when you can relax and let things unfold as they will and go with the flow. When I'm in that zone, life is so much easier. It's so much less work. But for some reason, I always feel like I'm swimming upstream. I don't always feel like that, but there are times, especially when there's something that I want, when I have an idea of what I want it to look like, that's when things tend to be a little bit more clunky, a little bit more difficult. And if I don't take myself too seriously, if I don't take any of this stuff too seriously, it's serious business, but we have to be able to look at it with joy. I have to be able to break it down and not be so serious. Because when I'm so serious, it's so much more work. And if I was able to be patient, relax, and let it go and let it come. Instead of just letting it go, letting it come. Let the good come. Let the bad come. Let life unfold. When I'm not trying so hard to fit everything to be a certain way, then it's easier. Then it's better. Then it tends to be more fulfilling and better than anything I could dream of. Because usually, since I've been in this journey, on this journey of spiritual and self-fulfillment, right? All of my ideas and all of my thoughts have been like this compared to what's actually come, like what's actually been the result of this work. And I have to trust that because there's evidence that that works, right? There's evidence that that is true. So if I lean into that and if I just like, you know, trust fall into that, then I think I'm going to try it today. I think that's what I'm supposed to hear. And you're supposed to hear too because you're listening. And I'm glad you are. And I hope you have a wonderful day. And do check out our podcast. I have two friends of mine. We do a podcast called Telling on Ourselves, and it's on at Apple Podcasts and Stitcher and all the other Spotify, all those ones. And you can also check out my blog at, what is it, awkwardandawesome.org. And I'm on Facebook too, all over the place. So I hope you have a wonderful day, and I will be back tomorrow. I missed yesterday, but I will be back mañana, Labor Day. Be good.